Are you just getting started with SOTI MobiControl? Looking for getting started guides and walkthroughs? Then look no further. This series of videos will provide you with the must-have information, tips and tricks as you begin your journey. Join us, SOTI's team of principal instructors, as we work through key information about your SOTI MobiControl deployment. We'll look at enrolling devices, assigning configurations and much more.
As more and more organizations use a variety of different devices across their operations, the need to safeguard those devices from threats, configure them for their intended use, and apply applications and tools for employees, along with being able to manage these devices remotely, has never been greater. And the outworking of this will depend on each specific organization. Let's look at an example. We have an organization that operates over multiple different sites, and their IT team can't be everywhere. As well, they have devices connected to Wi-Fi on site. There are also devices that are assigned to drivers.
And this sort of example is common across a whole variety of different industries. Retail, for example, with the different stores and the transportation network behind that. Transport and logistics with depots and deliveries. Manufacturing, healthcare, and many others. And depending where the device is situated, it will have a specific purpose. Take this one for example. This device has been configured to only allow the user to see and use a subset of applications, and they cannot get out of the screen.
Now, Anton, that looks great. It will be very useful for any employee to help them focus in productivity, as well as removing any unnecessary items that this device may have. In addition, we keep the devices safe by offering network certificates, approved Wi-Fi and VPN access, and so many other items that can be provisioned into this device. Additionally, also, how about if the organization is just looking for a single app or resource to be available on that device?
That's a really good question, David. Well, let's look at another use case. For example, a device that's being used as a digital signage or a public-facing screen and something that's very easy to configure. So let's keep this in mind. But how can we get started? What do we need to know? Well, first, SOTI MobiControl empowers organizations by providing visibility, control, and security over their device fleet, allowing what we've just seen to be achieved and much, much more.
SOTI MobiControl can be deployed either in the cloud or on-premise. There are many components that make up a SOTI MobiControl deployment service, but there are some important ones to keep in mind. Now, Richard, could you please walk us through the components?
Absolutely, so let's take a look. And as you mentioned, Anton, SOTI MobiControl can be deployed both cloud or on-premise. And there are a number of different components that make up the SOTI MobiControl deployment. We're not gonna look at every single one, but here we can see two key ones to consider. We have the deployment server or service and the management server or service. Now, the deployment server is responsible for device communication, whereas the management server looks after SOTI MobiControl running and also the web console interaction. So when you're making a change and you're applying a change using your web console, the management server is making sure that that is recorded and those settings are applied to the database that we can see on screen.
So Richard, how does the devices communicating to the deployment server?
Well, that's a good question. Now, this will vary a little bit dependent on the device platform, and we'll see a little bit more about that in a few minutes' time. But commonly, there'll be an agent, an app that exists on the device. So when you're applying a change on your web console, that's stored, and then the deployment server will send that information to the device, and then the agent will make sure that that is applied to the device. So for example, a lockdown that we saw previously, restricting the device to a subset of applications dependent on the user's needs. So altogether, as you are using your web console, these components are interacting along with many others to make sure devices are customized to organizations' needs. So we've just seen a little bit of information in terms of how the deployment is working under the hood, but there are some other considerations to keep in mind as well.
Absolutely, Richard. As a matter of fact, very important ones. And these three things are going to allow us to see what we can do and what we're not allowed to do with devices. And think of them as giving us the Lego pieces in the set that we can actually use to configure devices accordingly. And there are gonna be three elements. Number one is going to be the platforms that are supported with SOTI MobiControl. So John, can you remind the audience, what are the platforms that we support?
So we have the Google platform, the Apple platform, Windows and Linux.
Now, at a lesser consideration, the versions of this platform is also going to be important to see what we have available. But now we move on to something called form factor. Now, form factor is the hardware that make up those devices. Now, you can have a digital signage, you can have a tablet, you can have a scanner or a laptop. All those things will have different things that you can configure, different features that you can enable on those devices as well. But the third one is perhaps the most important one. And to make things clear, I'm going to ask you, John, to do me a favor. I noticed you have something right there next to you. What's that? Yeah, is that your personal device?
Yes, it is.
All right, can you please do me a favor and put it in my hand? All right. Now, I need to ask you for a question. How do you feel when I'm holding it in my hand, John?
I feel a little bit apprehensive, David.
And there's a reason for that. Now, devices today hold all of our lives. They follow us everywhere. They are devices that are holding way too much that maybe as an organization we don't need to know. And this is what determines the ownership of the device. Now, we have terminology such as BYOD or corporate owned business only, and that determines who owns the device. So in the case of John, you know, he has every right to feel not happy about me holding that device. Now, this is the third one that's gonna determine which pieces we can use in order to make the configuration of these devices work for our organization, control the security of our data and the hardware versus also protecting the privacy of John. Now, from now on, our demonstrations and walkthroughs are going to focus on the corporate-owned business-only ownership of devices, and we also are going to be focusing on the Android Enterprise platform.
You're now familiar with the key components of SOTI MobiControl, how to navigate the console, manage devices, and configure essential policies. This foundation sets you up to start managing your devices with more confidence and control. Want to dive deeper? Check out more resources in SOTI Academy and our YouTube channel. Whether you're looking for step-by-step guides or quick feature overviews, we've got you covered. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel for more resources and updates.